Hi guys, I'm going to do a quick run through about what we're doing up here at our third garden plot, a little place I've been calling our homestead without a home. Little house right here. I did get this little area of the roof re-roofed because the roofing that was on there was just really bad. And there was some roll roofing in there. And it didn't cost me anything, so I got out here and covered it up. A little pear tree here has surprised me. It is coming out. I didn't think it would. The nursery that we ordered it from sent it to us with the roots just really hacked up bad. These hedges here, I started kind of trimming them up to make them look better. And I never really did like the hedges here. I want something here to block the sight down into the place. But I never really did like these hedges because, you know, it's a mixture of a lot of different things. Well, when I got started cutting it, I found wild roses growing through here. And these particular wild roses have the rose hips that we like the best. So the thought that I've had is I'm going to carefully cut this stuff out and leave all the wild roses in there. And then I'm going to put a trellis thing across here and have the wild roses kind of growing up on it, and that should also help to block the sight down in here. And then here I'm going to leave open, but with a, I'm going to put a gate there. And then what I'm going to do is at this point here up to there, I'm going to run a fence. And I'm taking that down, and then I want to backfill in here a little bit and do something to kind of protect the pear tree so that we can have parking here. Here we've got the butternut squash, and it's doing pretty good. Very satisfied with it. Over on the other side is the spaghetti squash. Thanks to Rob, I sure do appreciate the seeds you sent me, man. Next project that I want to do is right here. Is I want to build a three compartment compost bin, and I've got a pile here. It's a mixture of green material, wood, and horse manure. And then what, and I want to build another one down on the bottom. And then the next thing I want to do is get up through here, and I want to start chopping and clearing everything out. I'm going to get everything in a pile, and then I'm going to go rent a shredder for a day and just shred everything up, get it in the compost bin. Still haven't decided what I'm going to do with this here. I quite honestly kind of like having a wild looking little area here. Here's another pear tree, just like the other one up there. I didn't think it was going to make it, but it's doing well. I've got sweet dumpling squash planted in the little bins here. I haven't been able to finish the rock thing yet. So many other things coming up, but yeah, I've got big piles of rock down here at the bottom of the property that I need to get up here. I got sunflowers right in here. Right there is my quinoa. Over on the other side is sunflowers also. Over here, see if I can get close enough. Right in there is one little Johannes beer. That's a red currant. I would like to get a little bit more in there. I'd like to get about two or three more. I don't care for them that much. I like the black ones better, but my wife likes them. And we're thinking about that backside over there, actually leaving that to grow wild each year. There's a lot of wild flowers that have popped up over here. This is a Svechkin purple plum, and we're going to have some good plums this year. We've got a another one down on the bottom side, and we're going to have quite a few. I'm really looking forward to it because I love this. This is an English hawthorn. I was very happy to see this here. This can be used for medicinal purposes. Now, one has to be very careful with it, because this particular medicinal purpose is for high blood pressure. I kind of stopped right there because that's the one I was interested in, because a few years ago I had high blood pressure so bad that it almost killed me. Then the medicine that they gave me, a beta blocker, which was the strongest one that you could get on, it almost killed me. So I was fighting the high blood pressure and the beta blockers. And I really would have loved to have been able to try a natural medicine before I went on those doggone chemical things that they gave. This man has been giving us fits. I finally decided to quit thinking about it for right now, considering all the rest of the work that I got to do. And I threw out some buckwheat here. We'll see what happens. If it comes up, it does. If it doesn't, it doesn't. The raspberries. I think what we've decided to do is we're taking these out. My mother-in-law already has a pretty large area up at the house for raspberries. And I think what I'm going to try to do is transplant these down to there, and then I want to expand this bed, raise this front edge up to the back side right over here, and make this bed a little bit bigger. Well, as sorry looking as these trees are, I think we're going to have some good apples this year. I never knew the names of the trees. What types they were. All I know is the one I'm standing under right now is one that is supposed to be best for making juices and stuff. And then this one here is supposed to be best for good eating. And we did have some good eating apples there. On the other side of there is that other plum that I told you about. And then on the back side is a black walnut. And we got quite a few walnuts on there too. This cherry tree here is loaded with cherries. Problem is, it's about 60 feet tall. Man, look at all those cherries. And this is what I got to work with to try to get up in there. They, excuse me, they left this ladder here for us. And quite frankly, it scares me. All right, well, you guys, y'all have a real good day.